ओके, गुड इवनिंग ऑल. वेलकम टू प्लेक्सस 2D बूट कैंप. सो टुडे वी रीच टू द डे 4 एंड वी सी टुडे अबाउट द एनालिसिस ऑफ स्लोप स्टेबिलिटी. फर्स्ट वील चेक विदाउट द नेल्स एंड देन विद द नेल्स. सो व्हाट इज द मेन फैक्टर व्हिच वी हैव टू फाइंड हियर? दैट इज फैक्टर ऑफ सेफ्टी. सो नॉर्मली वेन एवर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द स्लोप स्टेबिलिटी, इन दैट केस वी नो दैट फैक्टर ऑफ सेफ्टी equals to the resisting force divided by the driving force. That means if the resisting force is the more than the driving force, that means the slope is well stable. If it is equal to 1, both is equal, so it is stable. And if it is less than 1, that means the slope is unstable. So we'll create a slope in the software and then we'll check that what is this, what is the value of factor of safety with the without the nails and with the soil nails, right? So first of all, we can see here, these are the objective for today's model. Firstly, we'll draw a slope model, then analyze the slope, then find the deformation, what deformation is showing there, and then find the factor of safety without nail and with the nails, right? So here I have created this slope geometry and soil property, in which you can see the x direction, it is showing the distance, and y direction, it is showing the elevation. And this is the upper layer, which property is showing here, and this is the lower layer, which properties are showing here. The slope is 2:1. So one is the horizontal and two is the horizontal and one is the vertical. So we'll put these properties in the input of the software for the upper layer and this for the lower layer. Then first we'll check without the nail, what is the effect, what is the deformation, and then what factor of safety we got, and then we check with the nails, right? And these are the coordinates which we'll prepare. So these coordinates we have to prepare in the software. So now next step, we move to the software, right? So I think it is clear, that is simple. We have to prepare a slope model here. So we'll start with the new project here, because we have to create the slope. So start with the new project. Now if I write it the slope stability without nails, right? And comment, I am left out this comment option. So in the next option, we'll see that it will be the plane strain 15 noded, and this will be the units are same. These are default unit. This side, this x will be the zero, x minimum will be the zero, and in the horizontally, it is the 40. And y minimum again 0 and y maximum is the 14. How we can check that? We can check it from here. This is 0 to 14 up to here, right? So I will put it as the 14, right? So now click on OK. So now for creating the soil model, we'll not create the borehole here, because this soil model is the embankment. This slope is the embankment and above the ground level. So we'll directly move to the structural part here, right? So in the structural part, when we move to structural part, then we'll create here. So now this is the vertical toolbar. So from here you can choose anything. So today we'll use this soil polygon, create soil polygon option, right? So we have to create this model on the software. So it will start it from 0, 0, then goes to 40, 0, and then 44, right? So this is the origin 0, 0. We can check in coordinates here where we are lying. So it is 0, 0 here. Then we move to the 40, 0. Am I clearly audible? Yes, can anyone can confirm?
Yes, sir. Yes,
Yes,
sir.
sir.
It's fine.
Okay. Okay. Thank you. And then it will be go to the 44, and then next one is the 34, then 29, and then 09. This is 30 and 4. Okay. This is 34. Then this is a 29, and then 09. And at the end, we click on the right click. So this first polygon is created. Now, second polygon we have to create over here because both have the different properties. If this whole one is a homogeneous, then we can create a single polygon for that thing, that in that case. Now we'll create the two polygons. So in second case, it is from 09 to 014 to 1014. From 09 to 014, and then this is 1014, and then 29. And right click, and now it's select this select option. And now we have these two layers, upper layer and bottom layers. So in upper layer we have to put the properties, and the bottom layer also we have the properties. So how we'll put the property on this? Can anyone tell me how we can put the property for this? From which option?
Materials.
Material.
Yeah, materials we will put. Show properties. Okay, this show properties from here. Because these are now soil, these are the polygons, but soil polygon. So I have to again move to the soil option first, not in a structure. I created the structure, but I have to move the soil part. So once I move to the soil part, now I have to show here materials and then add the new button. And here I am taking as upper layer and bottom layer. Upper layer, the model material model is Mohr Coulomb, drain type is this, and color you can change your choice. If you want to change the color, it's your choice. Now gamma is given there. These are the upper layer properties. So gamma is given 17. So if I take gamma unsaturated 17, so gamma saturated I can take means higher value than this one. So here
20. I'm taking
18. Higher value than this unsaturated, right? Then this will be the same. Whatever is given, we put these values in this only. Otherwise, all things will be kept as the default values, right? Then we have given this a new poison ratio is given, stiffness is given, C, phi, and xi is given. So we'll move to the parameters. So this stiffness is given. This is 15,000. So I'll write it the 15,000 here, and new also given 0.25, C, phi, and xi value is given 4, 20, and 0. So this will be 4, this will be 20, and this is 0. Right? And now everything other will be a constant here. Will not change those. So click on OK. And another is the bottom layer. Okay, in the bottom layer, the same parameters are there. And if you want to change the color, that can be, you can change that. And in this also again given that 18. So I can write it as the 18 and 19. Other values are same. Now parameters. In parameters is 25,000, 0.23, and 8250. 25,000, 0.23. Directly I am clicking on the enter and it is changing the options. 8, I think, what was that? 25. 25 and 0. Right, everything will be same. Okay, so now click on OK. So if I want to assign this, so directly I will drop it on the this polygon. So it is assigned in the both cases, right? So now up to here we have just created the soil properties and also created the structural part in the these models, right? So next one, now we have to go to the mesh generation, because once it is done, then next one we have to move to the mesh generation. So first, now I think you have clear on that. Firstly, we'll go with the soil property. If it is the soil, boreholes are given, or this below the ground surface is given, then we have created the boreholes. If directly the structure is given, soil structure like embankment, slopes, so in that case we'll create the structural part. And in structure we have embankment beams, plates, structure loads, so that all will be assigned from the this structural part, right? So next one we have to create the mesh. So mesh, directly we create the generate mesh. So if I generate this, so I'm keeping it as a medium. You can increase and decrease it, but that is not affecting what that much. Only the mesh will be changed. So now if we see this mesh, so this will look like this. So this is generated, and now in this area where you can see the size of mesh are low, in these areas the stresses are higher where the size of meshes are low. So now we can see after calculation how it is showing the deformed mesh in that case, and deformation also, right? So the next step to the staged construction. So when we move to the staged construction, so in this case this is the initial phase. So in the initial phase, what we can do here, we have to check it like this. And in this case the initial phase is there. So previously we have kept as a K naught procedure, right? So K naught procedure. So here it is showing that it is the K naught procedure. This will be the same here. This will not change because initial will be always same. Okay. So K naught procedure is for the when this layers are the horizontal. But if it is a non-horizontal layers, if it is a non-horizontal layers, in that case we have to use the gravity loading. So we'll change it from the K naught procedure to the gravity loading, because now we have the non-horizontal layers in this case, and this will be the stage construction same, and everything will be then same. Click on OK here. So initial will be generated, right? Then next one is the we have to now activate these layers. Actually we have assigned the layers, but we have not activated it yet, right? So now when we activating it, so if we right click on this bottom one, firstly I activate bottom one, so just click on this activate. So this will be activated. Now you can see this is activated and the top one is remaining. So I will activate this one too. So both one I have activated it, right? So both is activated, and now you can see both layers are visible here in color. So now in second case, phase two, I have to add here because I need to see the deformation. So initially in phase one, I have seen only that activated it. Now I have to add second one, phase two, which is called a deformation phase. So deformation, right? And in this I'll capture the initial phase. It will start from the phase which is the initial phase, and the calculation type is the plastic. It will not change. Stage construction, so everything will be same. And now I click on OK. So now in this case, if I run it up to here, so we will see that what is the result here. Okay, so if I run it, well, only we want to check how the deformation is showing in this slope. So view results. And now you can see here, this is a deformed mesh. So deformed mesh, if it is due to the its own weight. And if I see the deformation from here, so this type of deformation is showing. This type of deformation it is showing, the maximum deformation at this point here. And stresses also, you can see stresses in this, how the stresses are generated. So maximum stresses is zero. Stress is not generated because it is the self weight. If we apply the load from the top, then it will be generated. So deformed mesh is here. Now second thing, we have to calculate the factor of safety in this case. So how we calculate the factor of safety? So for factor of safety, we have to create another phase. That is another phase with the safety analysis. But in this case, you can create this phase by two way. One is, if you create this phase with starting from the initial phase, like now you can see here, if I am changing, here also it is changing. Now it is started from the deformation, and if I change it from the initial phase, so now it is started from the initial. It is bypassing the deformation phase. And this calculation type, now it calculation type is the safety, because we are checking the factor of safety. And the loading type is this, factor is all the 0.1, and these all will be same. So I want to check for this. This is zero displacement. This we have to check it. This reset displacement to zero. So now this we have created the phase two as safety. I am writing this as the safety phase. Okay. And click on OK. Again, I am running the or calculating the model. Okay, it is done. Now we can see here the output, and now you can understand that how we are studying in the courses, that how it is showing the deformation. And this is the deformed area, this which is slip surface, which we call as a slip surface. So in this slip surface, you can see two things are there. One is the driving force and another is the resisting force. So what can be the driving force here? What can be the driving force in this case?
The loading which is put up on that particular slope.
Loading is not applied here anyway.
Self-weight.
Its self weight is the its weight of this wedge is this you can say a driving force. And the resisting force,
that would be shear strength of coil.
Yeah, the resisting force is the cohesive property in between of this, you can say the shear strength of the soil. So now we want to find that what is the factor of safety of this slope. So that we can find by creating the curve. So we'll create the curve between the x-axis and the factor of safety, which is this summation m h f. So if I click here, so you can see it is showing this one. This is the factor of safety which is showing this straight line. So it is around 1.35. It is around 1.35. So how we can get the exact value? So exact value we can get from the this table. So if I check this table, so you can see here the at the last it is showing 1.352. So 1.352 is the factor of safety for in this case. So I am just closing this and saved off this curve, right? So in this case, if you want to take a snapshot of this model, so how you can take that? Because it is not visible here. Here it is not showing any factor of safety in this case. So you need to write something in this. Either you can take this picture from here and then add it in PowerPoint or in the paint, or you can directly write some text over here. So if I write some text over here, so it will be directly showing factor of safety equals to 1.352, right? So it will be shown here like the factor of safety 1.352 for this case. Okay, so another case is there, because this is the factor of safety of the slope without without any deformation. So if I check after the deformation, what will be then? What will be then means if I start this factor of safety after this deformation, is there any change? So we also can see that if I start it from the deformation part and then click OK and run the all the phases again. Okay, now we can check what is the changes here. So what is the change in the factor of safety? So first we check the deformation and curve. I'm just checking if there are any changes or not. So is there any change? No change, because in between of the I'm not saving this graph, because in between of the initial phase and deformation we have not changed anything here. We have not changed anything here, because this is and both are the same. Only we have just created the safety part after that. So I'm again starting it from the initial phase, and here we have checked the factor of safety of the slope without nail. Now second part will start it with the nails. Okay, so in the nails first we will assume that where is this sloping this failure part. So we can assume it will start it from here and then reach to the this point. Right, so we'll create the nails. So one nail is here, so we'll apply near about four nails in this. Okay, so how we can create that? So first we'll save as, we'll start the save as of this project. First we have to save this one also. So save and okay, and save as. Now I'm removing the without and it is the with nail, right? So for applying the nails, where I have to move, I have to move to the structural part, because in the structural part we can use the any input, we can apply the any input regarding to the any anything if we I want to apply here. Right. So how we can create the soil nail here? So I need to create a soil nail from here to inside here, and then grout that soil nail at the end, right? I have to grout that at the end so that that will be fixed here. If I create a nail from here to here, and if I will not grout that, that will be not fixed inside. So first I will create here one this node to node anchor, right? So node to node anchor I will create from this point to this point. Okay, right click. Then another I will create from here to here. Next one I will create from here, and last one, because here, you know, we do not need the larger one because it will be go up to here only. So I want to create these nails inside here up to here only. So now next one, I have to create the grout body also, because without grout body these nails will not be fixed here, right? So for the grout body I have another option here, which is the wait a second. So for grout body I have to move to the this create embedded beam row, right? Embedded beam row, and this will be I created from here to only these two boxes I am taking for the grouting, right? I am assuming that this nail is started from here to here, and at the last this line I have grouted. Okay, and then right click from here to here. So now I have created four nails here and then grouted it. Okay, so now I need to give the property to it. So for property of this anchor, I can directly move here and assign from this part, node to node anchor. So this will be the nail, and if I change the color of this, well, it should be black. So stiffness will be, I'm using 5. E5, and spacing between these, I'm taking it around. This is how much this one, these are the 1 meter by 1 meter, so this will be 1 meter and 1.5, right? So 1 meter and 2, around 2. So 2 meter I am taking the distance between these two nails, right? So okay, and same I will provide the properties to all. Done. Now I need to give to this grout body. So for this grout body, again I can click here and I'll click on the plus option, and I will write here the grout. Body. Okay. And color will be same. The properties for this will be the stiffness 7.07. This is again I am taking from the manual. Okay. These readings or properties we can take from any literature. This E6, gamma will be 0 here, and this is predefined massive diameter. So diameter, I'm taking 0.3 meter, 300 mm only, and spacing. No need to write this. Then this one. This will be skin resistance. Skin resistance. I'm taking 400 kN per meter and 400 kN per meter. And other thing, the default values. So click on OK. And
excuse
now
me, sir,
I will
in the
provide
material.
For the yes.
Excuse me, sir. Is the material type going to be elastic for the grout?
Yeah, elastic.
Okay,
it will be elastic, yeah. And then again, this one also. But I want to be continue of this. So this is showing here behavior. This is pipe behavior showing. So I will change it to grout body. So this will be changed from this pile behavior to the grout body. And now, so it is looking so deeper, but we can reduce it. So if we reduce it up to here and rest, we can increase the grout body, but no issue. These may be according to the design, that how much length it is required, right? So now I have created these, and next one. So once this is done, then next one is the mesh generation. So now I am making these all as the one group, because I need to activate these all together. So if I select these all, right click and make as a group. So now it is showing here the group option. So I do not need to activate these all individually, rather than I can activate it once, one only. So now second, so whenever we are creating or we are changing in the soil model or the structure, so after that we have to create the mesh. Okay, so if you see this mesh, now we can see this is showing the piles are these nails are inserted into the slope, right? Close it and now move to the stage construction. So now initial phase will be the same. So in deformation phase, earlier we have not done anything here, but now what we will do, we will activate these all things, these all nails here in this deformation. So if I activate it, either I can click on this or right click and activate each one, or I have created a group here. So if I click on this, so all will be activated together, right? So now again, I am now our part will be over here. So same safety also I have already done. So now we calculate it. Okay, so now if we check the output, now you can see this is the deformed, this is a deformation which is showing, this is the deformation which is showing, right? So if we check the factor of safety, now our main part is to finding the factor of safety after using nails. So here, new of safety. So what is the value of factor of safety here? So it is again near about 1. So if we check the exact value, 1.332. Now I am saving this graph here. So it is showing the 1.332. If I am same, why it is showing 1.332? Because the safety analysis is directly from the initial phase. This is not from the deformation phase where we have activated the these nails. So in this we can write here. The factor of safety is 1.332. Okay. Now, second case is when we are creating this safety analysis after applying the nails. So then what will be happening here? Okay, now we can see the result. So first of all, the deformation. So now it is showing the deformation with the nails also. Earlier it was showing from here, now it is showing with the nails up to here also. So means what is there in this case now? Earlier this was the failure here, now it is showing that this whole area will be grouted, and now if this loop will fail, so it will fail this total from here to here. So that doesn't mean, so now we'll see the factor of safety. What is the change in the factor of safety after applying the nails? It should be increased. Okay, now you can see it goes 1.5, 1.512. So now we can see that if we are changing the applying the nails in this, so how much it is? 1.5. So we can write it here, 1.5 after nails. Factor of safety, nail will be 1.5. Right. So these are the changes when we are applying nails and with nail and without nail. Right. So I think this is we have learned here how to use the slopes analysis and how to find the factor of safety with the nail and without nail. So now I am stopping here it. So thank you so much. Now we can discuss about this.
Good evening, sir.
Yeah, good evening.
Sir, actually, I want to know that you had placed 4 nails.
Yeah.
And all are at nearly same angle.
Yes. Yeah.
So when we want to check its front view, that how they are placed from front, that we can come to know.
Yeah. Actually, when you study about the soil nail, entering the soil nail, so these nails are entered in each horizontal and vertically, both sides.
Okay,
the
sir.
Spacing of the vertical will be the same, and horizontal, okay, all horizontal spacing should be same.
Okay. So means that
angle will be drawing, same. Angle will be same for all.
Okay. Means the drawing which was shown by you, that can be seen from front view also.
Yeah, it can be seen front view if we are using the 3D model. In 2D
okay.
model, we can see only one view.
It's okay.
2D view.
Sir, the commands which we are using in Plexus 2D are almost similar in 3D also?
Yeah, yeah, same.
Actually, sir, I am also working on this particular saw nailing, and I want to, you may say, put up 6 nails in a rectangular pattern.
Yeah.
So
you
I
can,
should
you can put you can put in that in 3D. You can do anything. That is very.
Okay. So mean to say, I need to go for 3D Plexus 3D.
Yeah, that will be the more.
Convenient.
Are higher in there. Visuals are higher in there.
Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot.
Again.
Just to add to that, the question that was asked by Mr. Aman, what is the name? Aman Pri.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, great. Yeah, because I have used both Plexus 2D and Plexus 3D, and I know the modeling procedure will be entirely different because there you have to imagine everything in 3D, is it not? So when you start working in 2D, what happens that you see the only cross section, okay? And when you are putting nails, so although we are saying it is nail, whatever the element that you use, either node to node or whether you use plate element, I've seen majority of people use plate element. Okay, but then you know that when you are modeling in 2D using plate element, so you have to actually calculate the thickness, is it not? The thickness, because you are putting 4, 3 or 4 nails, okay, but then the equivalent value of EI, because when you are using plate element, so you have to give input parameter like EI, okay, EA, like that. Is it not? So there you
yes,
have
sir.
To actually do the calculation for the equivalent value of EI, flexure rigidity and axial stiffness. So that calculation requires. Yeah, that calculation requires. But in 3D, that problem is eliminated because you are directly giving the nails. But as you mentioned that it will not be possible to view the front because you cannot rotate, is it not?
Yes, sir. Because I was working on different nail patterns, and
mm-hmm.
that's why, because if we see from the front, so it could be giving the you must say proper look, or it would be very easy for other person to make him
understand
that I'm using this type of pattern I'm using this, and this would be the spacing which I'm considering from the front if someone looks from the front.
Yeah. So for that you have to go for 3D, because
okay.
when you are
okay.
working on pattern, when you are working on number of nails and their
yes, sir, yes,
arrangement, then you have to definitely go for 3D. Because the 2D is not going to work.
Okay, sir, fine.
And I'm sure that the participants who have attended this session, they must have benefited in two aspects. One, understanding the switch on and switch off mode of this Plexus feature. See, what Vidyasagar did during the modeling, he provided everything, including the elements, nail elements. But then he performed the calculations in two phases, like one without nailing and one another one with the nails. So he was just switching on and switching off. Did you observe that? Did you observe, everybody? You can write in the chat box if you have observed that feature.
Yes, sir.
That's great. So this is the unique feature of Plexus, and that is the reason it is most preferred and the most widely used software. And the second feature is you understood the factor of safety calculation. So those who are geotechnical engineers, they know that if you have calculated the factor of safety in normal circumstances or using limit equilibrium method, So what you have done, you have just taken the ratio of restoring force to the driving force. That is the basic definition of heterostasis when you use limit equilibrium method. So, but then here in Plexus, in all finite element tools, this strength reduction technique is used. I will just mention the name of the technique, strength reduction technique. Okay. This is, I just want to know from you that are you aware of this strength reduction technique? Just yes or no?
No, sir, I am not having any idea.
Yeah. The strength reduction technique, this is the technique which is developed by Matsui and Sen, okay, in the year 1992. Okay. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to give reference of this published paper. Okay, the paper was published in Soils and Foundation in the year 1992. And the title of the paper is Finite Element Slope Stability Analysis by Strength Reduction Technique. Shear Strength Reduction Technique. Okay. And it is one of the most referred and the most cited manuscript.
Sir, because if you could please put up the link in the chat box, it would be very
beneficial. I will share the manuscript itself. Because
okay, that's too good, sir, too good.
Yeah, I share that manuscript and you go through that. And this is entirely different from the factor of safety calculation that we normally do using limit equilibrium method. So it's just a very vague way of explaining the things. It's a very crude way of explaining the things. That how do you define factor of safety? What exactly strength reduction technique do? So you must have studied, those who have studied the shear strength chapter in soil mechanics, there you have understood the factor of safety definition, is it not? So what do you do? How do you define factor of safety? Factor of safety is the shear strength divided by the shear stress applied, is it not? Factor of safety is nothing but the shear strength divided by the shear stress. Okay.
Yes, sir.
And if you just replace shear stress and factor of safety. So shear stress will be the shear strength divided by factor of safety. Is it not? Shear stress will be shear strength divided by factor of safety. Okay. Now what strength reduction technique does, it increases the factor. It starts from one and then it iterates either on the higher side or on the lower side. Okay. Just to make sure that the shear stress is equal to the shear strength. So shear stress is calculated based on the external load, based on the initial stresses or gravity stresses, and you can calculate the shear stress, okay, in the model. And shear strength, because you have already given the C and phi parameters, so you know the shear strength of the soil. Okay, now what you are going to do, you reduce this shear strength value or increase the shear strength value. How you can reduce? By taking factor of safety more than one. How you can reduce? Because it can easily compare. Na? You can write a coding that whether shear stress is more than shear strength or shear stress is less than shear strength. Is it not? And accordingly, you can either increase or decrease the factor of safety. So in this process, what it does, it tries to equate the shear stress and reduce by reducing the shear strength. And then it reports the factor by which whether you have increased or reduced the shear strength to make it equal to the shear stress will be defined as the factor of safety of that slope. Are you clear?
In that case, sir, we are considering factor of safety as one.
No. It's not factor of safety one. It is definitely going to start with from somewhere. No? It is going to start
okay.
From it will start from one, but then it will either increase or decrease. Like maybe it can go to 1.1 or 1.05 or maybe 0.95. Okay. So it will just try to equate the factor of shear stress with shear strength. and a factor by which it has either increased the shear strength or reduced the shear strength will be the factor of safety of that model.
Okay.
Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So that is the a very crude way of explaining the things. Those who are the beginners or those who don't know who are just trying to understand this topic. So for them, this is just a crude explanation of strength reduction technique. But then I will suggest that if you are really interested in this technique, then go through this manuscript I will share in the group, and then try read and understand.
Okay.
So that will be very helpful. Okay, because this is the technique which is used in all FEM tools. Then coming to some of the questions that are asked, I can just go through because we still have some time to discuss. And by the time, if anyone wants to have a discussion or if he wants to say something about this question, you can unmute and then you can talk about that.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, please.
Thank you for this great session. I'm agree for the soil without kneeling for the slopes, no problem. But for soil with kneeling, I think simulation for the soil kneeling is not correct, because soil kneeling is a system from top to bottom. So mm-hmm. I think it should be make pore holes and make yeah. layers of the soil and make a stage for construction soil kneeling, because soil kneeling is not from bottom to top. No, it's from top to bottom, 1 meter. And the second point, it's no simulation for the shoot creep for the face of the slopes. So I wanted to explain this point. Thank you.
Okay. So that's a good point. Actually, when you do the soil kneeling, okay, I just want to understand from you, okay, what is the difference between soil kneeling and see, you do the soil kneeling when you work with the natural slope, is it not? If I am correct.
Yes, I am in the my PhD was in the soil kneeling. So I make a physical model for soil kneeling. I make it stage every 1 meter to excavate, and then put the nailing and another, and put the shoot create for the face of the slopes. Then the second stage, then the fourth stage, and so on. And they make a parametric study for the soil kneeling length and distance and the slope itself.
Mm-hmm. So that's true, because when you do the things in that field, suppose you are, why do you provide soil kneeling? Soil kneeling is used for the excavated slope, is it not? And you always excavate from top to bottom. Okay, you never go from bottom to top. So that you mean to say? And obviously we have to simulate the stage construction, because you excavate for 1 meter, then you put the nails, and then again you go down for 1 meter, and then again you put the nail. So that way should be done. This is the realistic treatment of the field condition. Like if you want to simulate the field condition, this is the real way of doing that. But then here we have just wanted to demonstrate that how the stability of slope is affected when you provide nails or when there is no nail. Okay, so it was just for the demonstration purpose, but definitely when you try to solve the realistic problem, there you have to simulate the field condition, and you have correctly said that you go stage by stage. So that can also be easily done in practice.
Okay, yes, thank you. Thank you, sir.
Sir, actually, nails are inserted into excavated level. You know, first we excavate, then we insert the nail. Then and nails are given where we required a vertical slope, not in the this angle slope. A vertical, where we require a large area, there we are providing the nails. But in natural slope, we are inserting the short nails and then grouting them with the pressure. That is increasing the slope stability by inserting the nails. Firstly, we make the bore hole, then insert the nails there, and then grout these nails inside there. So
yes, that's called the rock bolting, not soil nailing.
Rock bolting or soil bolting.
Yes, that's right. To make this to increase the factor of safety like this, but it is not soil nailing.
Yeah, we cannot say it is soil nailing. Right, exactly right. But this is just for a visual that how we are changing the factor of safety when we are inserting the rock bolts. And if we nails also increasing, but that is the vertically. The most of the projects are done in the soil nailing to increase the area where we want to work. And vertical design is there, vertical cutting is there, and vertically, and then inclinedly they are inserting the soil nails there.
Sir, please let me know that when we basically have to decide that this particular type of rock can be stabilized to nailing, because there are more than 1,000 types of rock which may have different dip angle and different internal strength. So what are the main features, main characteristics due to which we can classify that rock which can be stabilized due to nailing?
See, first of all, when there is no nail and there is a slope, okay. So what do you do? What is your first step? Your first step is to check the stability of that slope. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Now, to check that slope stability, you try to get the properties of the soil. Okay, and not only the properties of soil, you also discuss with the geologist, geological features, geological settings, everything is analyzed. And then you try to first get the factor of safety of that slope. Now, suppose you want to change the geometry of that slope, or you want to do some kind of construction on the top of that slope. Okay, and for that, you want to check whether this slope will be stable or not. If you change the geometry, if you do some kind of construction on that slope, either on the top or on the slope itself, so that you need to check the stability. Now suppose you applied the load or you change the geometry, and then you found that the factor of safety is now, it has gone down. The minimum level of factor of safety is suggested as 1.5. And now suppose it has gone down to 1.1. But then again, you need to check whether the slope failure is shallow or it is deep, is it not? Because you cannot provide nails of 10 meter, 20 meter, 30 meter, something like that, is it not?
Yes, sir.
So these kind of techniques, like soil nailing techniques or other techniques, they are useful, they are helpful, or for a shallow failures. Okay, shallow failure, so that you can easily put nail of 10 meter, 12 meter, okay, inside the slope, and then you can ensure that slope is stable. But a deep seated failure, a very high mass movement, for a very high mass movement, I don't think that soil nailing will be an effective tool for that. Other methods are adopted to protect the slope. Okay, so everywhere you cannot use the soil nailing. You need to see the
thank factor. You, sir. You got it.
Yeah.
Sir, as per your experience, could you tell me that what's the maximum dia and maximum length of nails which we can use in the field?
See. So far, I have seen people using the diameter of maybe 36 mm or 38 mm has been used, because you cannot work with a small diameter nails. It is not going to, otherwise you have to put lot of nails. But then if you put large diameter nails, then spacing will be increased. So that also should be practical, is it not? So
Yes, sir.
With that, it has.
So that's why just I'm asking from just based on your experience, based on if you had studied some of the case studies or some paper, those are based on those type of studies.
So nowadays, like you know that you have equipments that can be used and that can be installed, that can help you in installing the nails, is it not? So earlier, like I have seen some of the case studies where I visited the site also, where they were doing things manually. But then when you deal with the manual work, when laborers are putting nails by creating bore holes or kind of hole in the slope, then there you cannot work with these heavy large diameter nails, is it not? Because it will be difficult to handle. So there they were, maybe 20, 24, 28, something like that. With that they were working.
Okay, sir. And sir, could you please tell about some length part?
Length was 5 to 8 meters. Okay, but
okay.
So normally the diameter is between 19 to maybe 20 mm or 25 mm in that range is there in normal circumstances. Okay, diameters are in that range, and length can go up to 5 meter, because normally as per the recommendation, the length of the nails is normally taken as 75% of the height of the slope that you want to support, is it not?
Yes, sir. 0.7H to 1H.
So
based upon potential failure surface area, we should cross the nails above the potential, across the potential failure surface area.
So that's why I mentioned that if the potential failure surface is deep inside, is it not? So their nail will not be effective, because your nail will not be able to cross that failure surface and then provide resistance to the movement, is it not? So for deep seated failure, for the potential surface is quite inside, then it will be difficult. So normally from practical point of view, that people have tried, even trial nail walls have been up 350 feet or something like that. Okay, good height has been achieved with this trial nailing technique. But then they are going in stages, and then they are providing some kind of bombs in between, and then they are increasing the height. So bomb, I am sure that you are aware of this term bomb, which is used.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Yes,
so even if you are going vertical, you have to provide some kind of berm so that you can manage the slope, is it not?
Yes, so staged slopes will provide at different stages by providing horizontal berms of a certain interval of depth.
True. If I see some other question here in the chat box. Yeah, dynamic analysis. Ashwini, are you here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, see, the software that we are using, and for demonstration purpose, it may be either trial version or maybe black version. Yeah, I'm not sure. But then we have restricted our limitations on dynamic features. Is it not? Because we are not in the campus, and we are not in the computer lab where this software, Praxis software, is installed, because we have a 12 license for this Praxis software. And there, if you come and visit to us, maybe we can plan, once this pandemic situation is over, then we can plan this Praxis workshop, and we can see if we can demonstrate, or we can give you training from our lab. Okay, so if we are able to do that from our lab, then we will be able to demonstrate all the features that Praxis has. But currently there are limitations, and then limitations of time, limitations of facilities, everything is there. So we are trying our level best to make sure that you learn the maximum, is it not?
Yes, sir. with restriction we have can't, but we'll look forward if your case LPU is providing more workshops in the future. Will be very
that is our plan only, because we started with the small scale boot camp, but then I know when I plan training on Plexus, it's a 5 days training from 9 to 5, so that I plan. So there I try to give all the input that are available, but then students are there with us in the lab, and they learn with us in a physical setup. So it's easy in online mode. Even if I can demonstrate, but then you will not be having any hands-on experience on those things, because you will not be able to use softwares, okay, in this online mode. So only you can observe like a movie, and then you can go back and discuss that what happened in today's movie. Okay, it is just like that. So we will plan, definitely we'll plan, and we can see that if we can give more input in sessions like this. So if you are really motivated and excited to learn from us, we will be happy to deliver that.
Yes, sir. We are eager to learn. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much.